Welcome back, 4-H'ers. This presentation is going to be fairly short. It only covers three orders and three insects within these orders, and it only is for intermediates and seniors. So juniors, you guys, at this point for 2018's contest, don't need to know this information. First order we're going to look at is called Mecoptera. Mecoptera are scorpion flies, and they're a very uncommonly seen insect. Doesn't mean that they're very rare, but they're kind of an interesting looking guy. Their host is plants. They're considered inconsequential because they neither do enough bad or enough good to be one way or the other. And they do have a complete life cycle. And this is what they look like. They have that kind of cool pattern along the wings. They have this funny snout for a nose. They don't look like anything else. So hopefully you won't get confused with this guy and somebody else. They're called scorpion flies because the males have these enlarged deal in the back that looks like it's a scorpion stinger. But they can't sting. They don't hurt us. They're usually found in kind of a densely wooded areas, it seems like. They are predatory. They capture their food in flight, and they have chewing mouth parts. So complete life cycle, chewing mouth parts. Mandibulate is the other term for it. Inconsequential, and the host is going to be plants. Then we have Siphonaptera, and Siphonaptera are fleas. And so most of you guys are going to already know what the fleas look like. The host for the contest is a dog or a cat. There are many different species of fleas, and those species are usually host specific. But for the contest, all we need you to know is that they're found on dogs or cats. They are, of course, considered a pest. They're a nuisance to your pets. They're a parasite, but they also have the ability to, other species have the ability to transmit diseases. So these guys have sucking mouth parts because they're sucking the blood out of your pets. They feed on blood as adults, and the larvae also feed on blood, but they feed on dried blood. Well, how do you think that they get that dried blood? The adult fleas feed on the blood, so they poop out the blood, and the larva will feed on the fecal material of the adults. So larvae are always going to be found where the pets spend a lot of time because those droppings will come off of the animals. And a lot of times that you hear them called flea dirt because when it gets wet, it turns into blood because it's dried blood. They will sometimes bite humans. The host is the dog or the cat, but we're a second meal for them. Or the second best, so they will feed on us if they want to. They have a complete life cycle. You can see the ugly larva right there. The hosts are cats and dogs. They are considered a pest, and they have sucking mouth parts. These guys are also really super modified for the environment that they live in. They lack wings because wings would get in the way, although every other insect we've looked at up to this point have wings. So they should have wings, but they lost wings along the way because it was a disadvantage to have them. They have strong hind legs so that they can jump, saltatorial legs, so they can jump up onto the pet. Their body is flat like a knife, so it can squeeze in between the hairs and stay out of your way. They have antenna, but they're kind of tucked down this way so they don't get in the way. They have these little hairs and combs and barbs all along their body that are shaped, that face backwards, and so that helps that fleas stay stuck in the hair. If you try to pull it out, they get stuck. Those little barbs get stuck in the hair. So everything about them is modified for their environment, which is, although they're not a cool bug, that's kind of neat to know about them. And then our final order that we're going to look at is Trichoptera. Trichoptera are the caddisflies. Their host is, the adults are found near streams because they're aquatic as the larva. They're inconsequential. They neither do good or bad. They have a complete life cycle. So a caddisfly to me looks a little bit like a moth. And although you can't see it in this picture, the way that the wings are held is it's held like a tent over the body. So that's how I tell the difference between them and a moth. Plus, we don't have any moths that we're looking at in the contest that are shaped like this or look like this. Also, they have really long antenna, and moths don't have that long of antenna. They're pretty important to the aquatic community because the larvae are found in flowing streams, which means it's usually well oxygenated. So if you were like an aquatic specialist, you might catch these insects and it would tell you something about that body of water. The adults really don't live very long, and so they probably do not eat. So the mouth parts are pretty inconsequential as an adult, but as the larva, they do chew. And this is what the larva look like. The larva of some species are known to take debris, pebbles and other things, and kind of glue it together really tight with silk that they make, or their saliva. It makes a really, really tight glue. And so they'll crawl along the bottom of the water and poke out to eat and feed on food. And then crawl back in once they get their food, I guess. But what's neat about them is that people have learned that this glue is so tight, and so they will trick the caddisflies into utilizing gold pieces, like you see there, pearls, diamonds, and they'll make jewelry out of that stuff. So those are the three orders that we're just going to cover in this little tiny, tiny section. And next time we will start covering the lepidopterans, which are the butterflies and the moths that everybody likes so much.